Maybe he's onto something.
It doesn't really do damage, but there we go. Onto the TK. Good Maledict stun and that Chakram whirling death. Ice. He's pummeling them. Abed. Mega kill streak as they get the supernova. Focus down.
Bring
GH to the ground. And Miracle now left alone, surrounded by the entirety of EG. And Team Nigma starting to bleed out as Abed picks up a wicked sick triple kill. And Arteezy feeling completely untouchable as this Medusa.
Hex initiation bottom.
Yeah, Fly moving in. There's a dive away from GH, but the coil catching Miracle, morphling down, mind control with this arena, wants to force the fight, continuing on to kill off that buyback lion. Oh, Ice, failing to contend with mind control, might have to just ravage him here, but the BKB ends.
Good ravage, connects.
Perfect timing from Ice, allows Arteezy to open up and shred through Nigma. Miracle has bought back for this, but he won't be able to battle with EG, they've already retracted themselves from that bottom lane.
Fly with the nice hex initiation. They get a kill, they surround him, dies in the end, but he does not care too much. And now they need to be very careful how Miracle approaches the next fight.
They're bringing Tim's down, but it was spotted. Arteezy actually saw Tim's TP on that tier 2 with the vision. Ice is going to know that this Earth Spirit's in the area.
Gonna get ruptured. He's gonna turn out. Arteezy puts the BKB. They're ready to go in. The arena's down. Box gone. Gabby's down the ones. He's gonna be back for round two. But Tims, he's getting hit hard by the kisses. Tries to roll away, but Arteezy's got the kill. They turn, looking to lock down. Arteezy hex into the stun, but it's three dead on TNC. Only Armel and Boomy left alive. As EG, they're ready to look for the cleanup here. Armel trying to run, but Arteezy chases him down. Double kill for the Bloodseeker. Boomy is into the trees. They're hunting for him. They're not going to let Boomy go. He's going to drive for the TP out, but they've got the damage. It's a team wipe. EG, clean up. 17 to 5.
Dead farm. Lincoln Sphere, Witchblade, Blink Dagger.
So, potentially, this second Roshan, is it going to go to Nigma? EG don't want to hand it over for free. Ice, front lines, buys time, and the stun damage in onto DK. Mind control fingered. Hey, he's gone. The dieback on the DK while Miracle has BKB going. Whirling Axe is flowing out from the Troll Warlord 2, but Arteezy dropping low on that mana pool. Needs a bit of burst regen and a force staff away. We'll buy a bit of time for him, but they found the target they wanted. RTW's on the Deucer, claims the life. And Arteezy, you're right, does buy back. They want to control this Roshan. Another cast Maledict. RTW's been tapped down by Ice and Fly. Gets off his battle trance though. Even with Crit stun there and Arteezy Stonegaze, it's going to take
down
a long while, but Abed returns. The Prodigal Son is coming with a coil to catch three heroes, and Roshan for sure belongs to EG now. So EG, ready to go high ground again. Greater Treants there, spear back on the Prophet. Mind Control trying to set up on Arteezy, but Ice moving straight for GH. The Yondis popped as an arena thrown out from Mind Control.
They don't care about this arena.
No follow through whatsoever. They glyph up the tier 3 tower. Arteezy probably, you know, quite happy just to die there if it does happen.
No, don't die. He can just TP out.
There you go.
He cannot TP out.
The spear does put mind control out in the open, though. Arbed and Ice leaving the pick off. Arbed going to get hookshot in. Eondis pops out and he's going to jaunt away from the supernova landing. GH doesn't crash down onto anybody, and Kuro trapped inside the sprout. Arteezy's returned and they will lose Fly. That dive in from RTW causing issues for the backline of EG.
A double kill. Plug, but buyback.
Has to buy back at Ice with a Ravage. Destroys Miracle. No buyback on the Morphling. And RTW, he's being pummeled by Arteezy.
This might be it, Gary. I don't know if they can just straight up close out the game, because there will be some overtime damage. We can hear the screams in the background. You know, unfortunately, we did not have a crowd, but that feeling that you get from the players, just they're roaring when they're winning, and
it's
they call
over.
It.
Nice.
They walk right into them. They get in. They're with the avalanche. Arteezy able to get the BKB off in time. Bok trying to look towards Ice. The finger comes out. That's Ice gone. As Bok, he's heading straight for the back, guys. Moving over towards Fly. Crit turns with the BKB, but they're able to kill him off. Crit's gone. Two down. Tim's turns with another toss over on towards Arbed. They're trying to chase down Gabby, but Gabby, he's able to get away from the big course, take down Fly. Tim's will fall, but now it's only the two left alive, Arbed and Arteezy. Can they really withstand this brawl that TNC is bringing them? I don't think they can. Asunder from Arteezy comes out. He's looking to help out Arbed. It's actually enough. It keeps Arbed alive. Arbed's able to turn. Boomy goes down. EG, they're turning around here with the Sunder from Artor. The Sunder from Artor keeps EG's hopes alive here in
what
the second
play.
Game, as it's a triple kill for Arteezy, as Arteezy literally giving his health there to Arbed to allow Arbed to turn, fight back. EG, They finally are able to find that punch back in a team fight, and they do it with just the two of them.
That's very bad for them.
Oh, God.
A bit behind, and they accidentally two-timed it. They're fighting right on top of an EG ward if they pop on fly. Looks like that might happen.
They're going to move around here, down to the low ground. It pops. Immediately, the exorcism is going to go out. Jin Q trying to catch somebody here, but crit with a turnaround. Rolls immediately onto the Shadow Shaman, gets off a two-man silence with the Magnetize. Beautifully set up, but Faith Beyond is here to be able to counteract. Crit looking to be able to roll away. A Sunder goes out from Ave, but he is just dead. This magic damage is too much for him to handle, and that's even before Abed is here. Use the rest of his mana to catch up to Nothing to Say. There's a bit more for their Electric Vortex. Thank goodness Faith Beyond is there with the Storm, the Cyclone up in the air. That'll deny the Nothing to Say kill.
Maybe ILTW, but again, he's got two lives. Aegis is there, Battle Trance ready. They'll move in quickly and pop the Aegis, though. Team
Coil
Nygma.
Still available,
where's
so is
the
Stone
Gaze. Are they trying to save ILTW here? Because they've got the Coil, the Finger, the Maledict, it's all there. Dump it onto the Troll. He was left stranded, and EG in a perfect position to strike back onto Nygma. Mind Control running backwards towards his base, but ISSI with this huge pure damage burst finds the kill, and the egg is down. Yeah, evil geniuses on the doorstep of Team Nygma, just finding kill after.
Top with the ward sentry, they should know something's coming, but Arteezy.
Arteezy. Call first, follow up arrow, the neutral creeps the centaur. Is that going to be able to help Arteezy get out of this one? He's at half health, looking for the Sunder. Moonlight Shadow, he turns around, does manage to get off on Ame. Now the turret, Reflection goes out. Ice throws all the magic damage he has. They're going to leave behind Faith Beyond. He's going to be casualty of this failed gank on our tour. Looks like Y Psyblade again from Abed lines up to kill the captain of PSG LGD.
Rax taken out, they're going to back up, they're going to play it safe. Dude, this AoE Dragon Tail talent is absurd. Like, it doesn't matter, you don't have to hit the real Spectre. There's so many illusions around, but he just clicks stun and it catches the real Spectre every time. This talent's crazy.
Yeah, and they're onto the Ancient. Arteezy ready to try and close this up. In fact, he wants to pick up some more kills on the way out. Turns towards Gabby, the arena's out, they've caught the Spectre. Gabby's out, GG is called as EG will secure this second game. Both the...
Incisive move from Crit. Smoke gets popped. High ground ward. In comes Abed. Oh, the snowball save and roll away. Gets them out of the arena. And they go straight towards Kuroki. Abed also diving in deep with the Finger of Death. They take down the clockwork and Fly will follow him into the grave. A one for one trade, but the Ravage! Ice is there. Mind Control's low and they picked up RTW. Evil Genies is coming and clear Nygma off the face of the map. Oh, MC with a blink back. Orb forward, but he's TPing home and there's nothing to cancel.
Make sure they've got all three pushing in onto TNC when they look to go for the high ground advantages. Oh, Arteezy. Get the rupture down onto Tims into the blood right. Arteezy wants to push in for this, but the Ghost Scepter's out. Tims find himself some
back
time. Oh, he's on the cliff. They've got Arbed up there, but he is going to get cookied back down to the low ground. Ice Blast coming in. They've got the log down to take Arbed down the once. But now EG, they're ready for the chase down onto TNC. Gabby's going to get surged up to the high ground in time. Desperately trying to escape from EG here, but the arena's out. They've caught Armel. As Armel, trapped in the arena, will get cleaned up immediately. A buyback comes out for Tim's. Gabby dies instantly after he reincarnates. As Arteezy's diving into the base here, runs down Bok, looks over towards Boomy. Tim's trying to get away with the Ghost Scepter, but as it comes to an end, so does his life. Arteezy takes him out. The Ghost Scepter on Boomy will not save him this time round, as they've got the control through it all, as it's another team wipe by EG. 29-28.
Full AC coming out on the courier. Abed. They'll spend quite a bit of his gold to
Tims.
Toss back play. It's on Arteezy.
Another toss back, but the BKB's out straight away. Arteezy trying to step back over towards Tims. Arteezy looks towards now. Gabby popping the ult here. He's pushing in. Gabby's been hexed. They've got the space for the tower to go down. Armel's trying to jump in to push them back. Tims has brought back the coil down onto the two of the pack lines. Coming in with the horn. They're moving out of Fly. Fly's able to live it with the Ghost Scepter. Jump in from Tims. Shedding him with the combo onto Arteezy. Arteezy's able to turn. The holds his ground. Tims is going to fall slowly but surely. He's up to the high ground, but the damage is done. Tims will go down. He's out for 110. So's Boomy. Bok will manage to commit onto Crit, but Arteezy and Arbet, they're full HP. They cannot tackle these two. It's an ultra kill for Arteezy. As EG, they'll clean up the team fight yet again. As Arm out, it looks to be another catch here. Has he got any fancy footwork that he can pull off? It doesn't look
rampage.
Like it. And in fact, there it is. A deserved rampage there for Arteezy. After he's had a fantastic few fights here.